Hello friends, welcome to my channel. This side is Krishna Sharma. Friends, today we are going to discuss Coleridge's concept primary imagination and secondary imagination. Yes friends, so we are discussing primary and secondary imagination. These two are the important part from biography literature written in 1817. And it's a lot of time it has been discussed what is primary imagination and secondary imagination. So in this video I'll try to provide you some basic or practical point so that you can easily get what is primary and secondary imagination. So friends, let's talk about primary imagination. What is primary imagination? Friends, what we see, whatever we see around us, it means in nature what we see or what our mind observe. Actually, our mind observe all those points or those things in nature or around us. What we watch, we observe even face to face by our eyes or in movies or through any other person. So what we see, what we watch in nature, so our mind makes an image related to these topics, mountains, natures, forestations, peoples, related to these things. So our mind makes an image, what we observe, what we see, it means our mind goes to those points we generally watch, we observe. But so whatever mind make, those images are called primary images. As take an example, our mind watch, our mind watch TV, our minds watch, we are watching all those things. So our mind make a image related to these things. If we are wandering around in forest, we are seeing things around us. So our mind will make an image from all those nature things. So these are the images which are called primary image. It means whatever we see, whatever mind observe in this nature. So our mind make an image of different type of things which are in nature. So these are the images which are generally called primary images. So there is no big thing to understand it. Primary images are the images generally our mind makes through the nature. And now talks about secondary imagination. What is secondary imagination? Friends, firstly let know that what is secondary. It means after primary imagination, whatever mind make image, those are called secondary. So let's talk about in a practical way. Firstly, I tell you the secondary imagination is the concept of artist minds. It's not for general people. Say the mind of artist, poet and scientist. It means those people who have some extra sensibility, who think more than common people, who observe more than common people, they make secondary imagination. Now you can easily understand. It means very few percent of population, very few people as philosophers, scholars, scientists, poets. It means not a common people. Those people who have some extra sensibility, who have some, who have high IQ level, it means. So these peoples, as you know that scientists, philosophers, we generally say that they have some extras, they have some different talent, they are born talented, but actually they are not so. But in this world we are living, very few people who are really making some difference through their mind. They observe, they think beyond this nature. So what the image, those images of their minds creates are called secondary imagination. It means we generally, we are the common people, we see anything and our mind make an image related to that thing in this nature. But the artist or the poet or the philosophers think more than us. It means the common common people, observer, think whatever, they watch they see, but the artist, poet and philosophers, they think more than the common people. They think, they image things more than primary imagination. It means we generally see things and our mind makes image, but as our mind think beyond this limit, so it means our mind create a few different image in our mind. Those are called secondary imagination. Suppose that I tell you example, we watch tigers or wild animals in the nature. So we generally watch, we see the dangerous animals in the forest, jungle. So we make, our mind make an image that these are the part of our nature. So these type of images are called primary image. But suppose that we haven't seen dinosaurs. We haven't seen. But few of minds think that dinosaurs would have such types, structures. They make their mind imagine their body structure. So these are the images. So few minds create secondary imagination. So these type of imagination our mind creator called secondary imagination. So these are the primary and secondary imagination. So I have tried to tell you in a practical way. If you have any question, then you can write in comment box. I will try to reply all those questions. In my next video, I will discuss fancy and imagination. What is fancy and imagination? So thank you.